Hello, my name is Jimmy Rabin. I'm the Fortify Product Manager, and I'm here today to show you how to install, configure, and what's new in the Visual Studio 2019 Fortify extension. So you can install the extension simply by running the Fortify SCA Analyzers and Apps installer, ensuring that Visual Studio is closed, and selecting Visual Studio from under the Plugins heading. Once you've done that, you will see the Fortify extension here under the Extensions menu. That's new for 2019. If we click Analyze Solution and have a solution selected on the right there, it'll go ahead and run a local SCA scan where everything is performed locally, and then the results will be opened in the IDE. But in 2019, we have a new option to offload the SCA scan, which does take over your IDE while running, limiting your ability to continue to develop. So uploading your solution to CloudScan, where a dedicated SCA machine can perform the analysis phase, is a workflow that we see a lot of customers taking advantage of, and that's why we wanted to build it into the Visual Studio extension. If we go ahead and go to Options, we first need to ensure that we have an SSC URL and that you've tested the connection and provided it credentials, and that you have provided the Cloud Controller URL. You also can optionally choose to send your results to SSC, which I've chose to do. So, and you need to provide a Cloud Controller token that we can leverage that will provide authentication to uploading the results. You can create that token simply by going into Token Management section of SSC, generating a Cloud Controller token, and then providing that in the contents here. So if we click OK, I'm going to go ahead and bring our Fortify menu back and say Upload Solution to CloudScan. So because I've selected to choose where to upload the results when it's done, I'm going to choose riches.net, which is my sample application. This will take a few minutes, roughly the same time it takes to normally build this application. And you can see here that the translation command via the copy of MS Build that is shipped with SCA is being generated as we speak. Once that finishes, it will provide us with a job token that we can use to check on the status of our remote job. Once that's complete, we can download the results and do so in the IDE, or we could just log into SSC via the Chrome web browser or whatever your browser of choice and download the FPR or view the results in our web browser. So you have a number of options, but none of which include having to wait for SCA to finish running. All right, we can see our build has succeeded. The cloud scan commands are now being run. We're retrieving the cloud controller URL, the appropriate version of SCA necessary for this. We do require Windows sensor to run Windows scans, but that's likely been set up by your application security team. And now we can see it's been successfully uploaded and we've been given a job token. So I'm going to go ahead and copy that. You can also see it in the accounts console output as well. And I'm going to go ahead and show you how to generate a cloud scan command so you can check on the status of your scan if you wish to in your CLI. So cloud scan is a utility that comes with Fortify SCA. So if the bin directory for SCA is on your path, you can just call cloud scan. If not, CD into the bin directory of SCA. Run cloud scan dash URL for the controller, type status, and then provide your token that you were given. So we're going to go ahead and run that, and we can see that our job is running and the SCA upload state is queued, obviously while it's waiting for the scan to finish. If we were to look in SSC and go ahead and refresh this page, we can see our scan is running here. We could cancel that scan if we wanted to from here within SSC. And once that has completed, we can simply come in here to Fortify and we can say connect to SSC, and then we can choose our result file and that will download the results. I'm just going to quickly change this to all users since I haven't been allocated any issues. And if we were to look, we could see we have cross-site scripting issues, command injection issues to triage. We can go ahead and look at one of those if we'd like. Here you'll find the analysis trace. We can drag this window up to give ourselves a little bit more room. You can see the source or entry point of the untrusted information entering the system. We can see the execution point or sync where this is dynamically concatenated, and that we see we have SQL injection. We could go about fixing these issues, and then we could verify it with another remote scan if we so chose. So I appreciate you taking the time today to take a look at the Visual Studio extension. Hopefully you'll find some of these new features helpful. Thanks for listening and watching.